Hello developers, this is Nick from Anima, and today I'm going to show you how to instantly convert Figma components into clean boilerplate React components inside Figma using Anima. Anima's CodeGen AI is officially integrated into Figma's new dev mode panel, allowing you to generate, inspect, copy, download, and open your code in CodeSandbox in real time, even with read-only access. Let's get to it. First, open Figma and navigate to the Inspect panel. At the top of the panel, you'll find a toggle for Dev Mode. Click it, then switch to the Plugins tab. Next, we need to open Anima's integrated plugin for Dev Mode. If you don't see it on the list, you can type Anima into the search field. From there, you can run the plugin or pin it to the top of the panel for easy access. Now, select any Figma component, layer, or frame to get its corresponding React code in real time. In the right-hand panel, you'll see your component preview, along with runnable React code for the instance you selected, aka its usage. Click Source to get the full component definition, plus the associated CSS code, with Figma styles converted into CSS variables. And jump between all variants and subcomponents. You can also toggle between JavaScript and TypeScript using this dropdown, depending on your preferences. Once you're satisfied with your generated code, you have three options. You can copy snippets directly from Dev Mode by clicking this icon here. You can click the Download Selection button to get a zip file containing the complete code package for your selection. Or click Open in CodeSandbox to run your code instantly. You can see here that the component we've generated is stateful and interactive out of the box. You can find a link to this CodeSandbox in the description below. So there you have it. You can now turn Figma components into React components instantly inside Figma using Anima. Take it for a spin and let us know what you think in the comments or follow the Discord link in the description. And of course, don't forget to like and subscribe to see more tutorials like this one. Thanks for watching.